Hello children. So, as we have completed chapter 1, I am here to give you the solution of chapter 1, the exercises, objectives and question answers. Okay, so this is your SST book. We have already completed chapter 1 and I know you all are waiting for the solutions. So, let us start with the solution. Chapter 1, Story of Past History. So here we are. Exercise A, multiple choice questions. First, history is the study of, there are three options given and you all know very well which will be the answer. Yes, it is past events. Because future we don't know and present we are just living. So, history is the study of past. Prehistory is the period of time before written records. So, this will be your correct answer as we have already explained about history and prehistory. Next, the Renaissance was the revival of art and literature in the 14th to 17th centuries. So, this is the correct answer you will take here. Number 4, the modern period started in India during 18th century. Okay, past events before written records, 14th to 17th century and 18th century. Now, we come to true and false. History is the past of events, you all know this, so it will be true. Aristotle is called the father of history. False, you all know. Who is the father of history? Herodotus. History is the key to know our present. Yes, absolutely correct. Because when we come to know our past, we know our present in a better way. The Renaissance period began in Africa. It's wrong. It began in Europe. So, true, false, true, false is your answer. Now we come to fill in the blanks. First one, the word history is derived from the Greek word historia. Second, Herodotus is called the father of history. The study of history helps us to understand the basic nature of our society. Number 4, in India, the medieval period is marked between the 8th and 17th centuries. Okay, so number 1, Greek, number 2, Herodotus, number 3, society, number 4, medieval. So, let's turn the page and check for match the following. Correctly match column A with column B. Number 1, period before the invention of writing, of course, it's prehistoric. Inscriptions were written on pillars. You all have already learned pillars, coins, temple walls and all. Okay, so here option is given pillars. History provides us chronological record. And number 4, the Renaissance began in Europe. Almost the questions are same, so you all can understand it very easily. So here we complete our objective type exercises and now we will go to learn the question answers. You all can have a look here also. If you missed something, then answers are written here. For same chapter 1, number A, MCQs, multiple choice question, answers are here. You can see very clearly. True and false. Fill in the blanks. And match the followings. Here we are with the question answers. Standard 4, Social Studies, Story of Past, Chapter 1. First question is, what is the difference between prehistory and history? And we all know as I am well confident that you all must be knowing the answer. History means story of the past, and the past whose we have no records is known as prehistory, and the past whose written records are available is known as history. Second, state the advantages of studying history. Answer: there are many advantages of studying history, like we know more about our past. It helps us to know about human culture and civilization. It also helps us to lead a better life, to understand the development and different language. Number three question, explain the term Renaissance. So, Renaissance means the revival of art and literature in the 14th to 17th centuries. Number four question, why do we compartmentalize history? Explain. See children, answer is very easy and very clear. We need to compartmentalize or periodize history into ancient, medieval and modern periods to understand it in chronological order. What is the meaning of chronological? Step by step, day by day. Okay, we can't learn about Mahatma Gandhi and then a Mughal and then again old ones. We have to learn it accordingly, like the early men when they became civilized, then Mughal Empire, then Mahatma Gandhi. So this is the meaning of chronological order, which we can understand clearly when we go through the time periods. First one is ancient, second is medieval, and modern period is third, in which we are still living. So here is your solution for chapter 1. I hope this video is going to help you all. Thank you and be safe.